We are kicking off our song trip with the Indiana State Song, On the Banks of the Wabash. It was written by, the bugs are awful, it was written by Paul Dresser in 1897. And it, this is the Wabash River behind me. It was a very popular song. And it was not until the 1913 it was named the State Song of Indiana. This is the Wabash. The lighting is not good, but let's see if I can get closer. It's a really beautiful river. This is what we call our river because we live in a river town, and this is the river that flows through the downtown area where we live. So we walk over this river all the time, but not in this spot. This is Fort Weotenon, and Martin's going to tell you a little bit about Fort Weotenon. It's a historic site, and if you might recognize the name because of the Feast of the Hunter's Moon. The kind of reenactment thing that we do every year is located here. So right now it's empty. It doesn't look anything like it does when it's the feast, but this is the grounds that festival is on. And so, yeah, on the banks of the Wabash.
You lifted up a tile.
Look, I lifted up a tile.
You mama.
Okay, we are here on the banks of the Wabash River at the site of the old Fort Weotenon. Now, Weotenon was built in 1717 by the French, and it was the first fortified settlement here in what's now Indiana. And, of course, the rivers back in those days were a major transportation hub, and on the far bank of the river here there were Weah Indians who made their home, and here around the fort on the north bank of the river the Kickapoo Indians lived. And from 1717 until the French gave control of the fort to the British in 1760, this was a very peaceful place and a place of trading and a gathering spot for many different cultures and nations. After 1760, when the British took it over, it was a time of more strife and warfare, and it changed hands many times, first in Pontiac's uprising, then the Americans took it over during the Revolutionary War, and finally it fell into disuse, and the site was not rediscovered until the 1970s.
Fields. In the distance loom the woodlands clear and cool. Oftentimes my thoughts revert to scenes of childhood, where I first received my lessons, nature's school. But one thing there is missing from the picture. Without her face, it seems so incomplete. I long to see my mother in the doorway, as she stood there years ago, her boy to greet. Oh, the moonlight's fair tonight along the Wabash. Through the fields there comes the breath of new moon hay. Through the sycamores, the candlelights are gleaming. On the banks of a Wabash far away. Many years have passed since I strolled by the river. Arm in arm with sweetheart Mary by my side. It was there I tried to tell her that I loved her. It was there I begged of her to be my bride. Long years have passed since I strolled by the churchyard. She's sleeping there, my angel Mary dear. I loved her, but she thought I didn't mean it. Still, I'd give my future were she only here. Oh, the moonlight's fair tonight along the Wabash. From the fields there comes the breath of new-mown hay. Through the sycamores the candlelights are gleaming. Down the banks of the Wabash far away. Oh, the moonlight's fair tonight along the Wabash. From the fields there comes the breath of new-mown hay. Through the sycamores the candlelights are gleaming. On the banks of the Wabash far away. On the banks of the Wabash far away.
So this is a sycamore. It's a really big one. It goes all the way up. It's very tall. So when the sycamores, what's gleaming through the sycamores? Candlelights. When the candlelights are gleaming through the sycamores, this is the sycamore.